Hi there, Doug Stimmon with IT Creations with a Dell PowerEdge R760xa 2U rack server. This is one of those specialized servers designed for specific tasks. With support for dual 4th or 5th generation Intel Xeon scalable CPUs, it can sort up to 4 double-wide GPUs or up to 12 single-wide GPUs. I went over the PowerEdge R760 a while back, and you can see that video here. If you like our videos, hit that subscribe button. Let's get to it. With that kind of processing power, this system is well suited for tasks in AI, AI inference and training, machine learning, and deep learning applications. But it's also good for virtual desktop infrastructure, virtualization, render farms, high-performance computing. And you know, the more workloads I name, the less specialized this system seems. Compared to a maximum of 8 drives supported on the R760xa, the OG PowerEdge R760 also supports GPUs, but half as many. You do get support for up to 24 SAS, SATA, or NVMe drive bays, or up to 16 NVMe E3.S drives. We lost a few NVMe drives with the R760xa, but gained in the GPU category, as NVMe drives do use the same limited PCI lanes as the GPUs. And that is where the A suffix comes into play, for accelerators. The Dell PowerEdge R760xa does come with Dell's signature honeycomb bezel design, with optional LCD bezel or security bezel. The bezel with LED can also be used for the iDRAC address and for some management functions. Storage options include either 6 2.5-inch NVMe drive bays or an 8-bay 2.5-inch chassis with a combo NVMe SAS SATA SSD drive bays for a potential capacity of up to 122 terabytes. Another option is a 6-bay setup with E3.S Gen 5 NVMe storage devices for exceptional performance. Those will provide up to 46 terabytes of storage. Keep in mind, drive capacities are always changing, so that figure will change assuming Dell decides to upgrade the guides, which I can only imagine must be a pain in the Know what I mean? Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge R760xa server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that is listed or one that you can configure yourself at IT Creations valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video and save. To either side of that central drive bay are perforated panels as the double-wide GPUs are loaded towards the front of the system. The control panel on the left features the status LED indicators, drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe. Besides those, system health and status ID indicator. That status health indicator bar can also be outfitted with an optional integrated Dell Remote Access Controller or iDRAC QuickSync 2 indicator. QuickSync 2 accesses the integrated iDRAC management module to provide administrators with system status using Dell's OpenManage mobile app on a smartphone or tablet, iOS or Android. The right control panel has the power on button, a VGA port, USB port, and iDRAC Direct micro AB USB port. Handy if you don't opt for the optional QuickSync 2 indicator on the other side. Around the back of the system, the standard I/O panel includes a dedicated iDRAC RJ45 port to access the system remotely, plus 2 USB ports, a VGA port, and ID button. For more information on iDRAC, check out that link in the corner to view our video on the iDRAC 9.0 Enterprise for a short overview of the features. Currently installed in that OCP 3.0 slot is an NVIDIA Mellanox ConnectX OCP 3.0 NIC with dual 25 gigabit per second Ethernet ports. Also optional, a Broadcom 5720 LAN on motherboard card with dual RJ45 1 gigabit Ethernet ports to the left of the OCP mezzanine card slot. That LAM card can also be fitted with a direct liquid cooling for improved thermals, but the input-output tubes will take out the VGA port. To either side, a PSU with a primary on the left and the secondary on the right. There are several options for PSU wattages, including 2400 watt platinum and 2800 watt and 3200 watt titanium. Above each of those PSUs are two PCI slots, a BOSS N1 monolithic controller, also known as a Dell Boot Optimized Storage Subsystem, can be installed right next to the PCI slots and is strictly to boot the system. The BOSS supports one or two NVMe M.2 drives and can be configured with a RAID 0 for a single drive or RAID 1 for redundancy with both drives installed. The drives are hot swappable and easily replaced without removing the cover panel in the event of a drive failure or to upgrade. Outfitted with dual 5th generation top-end platinum Intel Xeon scalable processors, the Dell PowerEdge R760xa server can deliver up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads per CPU. Again at the top-end platinum category, for 4th generation Xeons, they will provide up to 60 physical cores and 120 virtual threads with Intel hyperthreading technology. Our system features dual fourth generation Intel Xeon Platinum 8468 processors with 48 physical cores, 96 virtual threads, and a thermal design power range of 350 watts each. Both support 8-channel memory architecture and 2 DIMMs per channel. To either side of those CPUs are 16 memory module slots apiece for 32 slots total. We've installed 32 64GB RDIMM DDR5 memory modules for up to 2 terabytes of memory. With 1 DIMM per channel, they will support 4800 megatransfers per second, but with 2 DIMMs per channel, only 4400 megatransfers per second. With 5th generation Intel Xeon scalable CPUs, you can realize speeds of up to 5600 megatransfers per second or 4400 megatransfers per second with 2 DIMMs per channel. I will mention that with gold or silver Intel Xeons, you might not get those memory speeds. At full capacity, the system can support up to 8 terabytes of memory with both processors installed, or just 4 terabytes with a single processor. Moving towards the front of the chassis, there's a bank of 6 hot swap fans, each of which can be removed separately, or for more complex repairs or upgrades, all of the fans are in a cage that can also be removed. The system can also support direct liquid cooling. In front of those, there is a right and left GPU riser module, each of which can support either 2 double-wide GPUs or 4 single-wide GPUs. Currently, there are 4 NVIDIA L40S in those GPU risers. A little bit more on that later. Between those, a dedicated area for a PERC or PowerEdge RAID controller. Again, many options for that, depending on your configuration and workload. 12th generation PERC cards provide RAID options for both SAS and NVMe drive types at 24 gigabits per second, or twice as fast as the 11th generation PERC controllers. There's also the S160 software RAID controller, which is part of the CPU architecture. Also optional is an internal USB card, serial port and VGA port. Heading to the back of the server, there are 2 risers, riser 1 and riser 4, with one above each of the PSUs. Just below in the middle, you can see the OCP 3.0 mezzanine card. Each of the risers has 2 PCI 5.0 by 16 slots. Up front, both GPU risers have 4 PCI 5.0 by 16 slots for support of either 2 double-wide GPUs or 4 single-wide GPUs per riser. The rear risers can also be outfitted with 2 single-wide GPUs each. With both front and rear risers outfitted with single-width GPUs, up to 12 can be installed, with network communications handled by the OCP 3.0 mezzanine card and optional LOM card. Only 4 double-wide GPUs can be installed, with 2 in each of the front GPU risers. For access to all riser slots, both CPUs must be installed, and there is no mixing of GPUs. Regarding double-wide GPUs, up to 4 Intel PVC 64GB at 300 watts, or the NVIDIA H100, H100 NVL, A40, A100, A800, A30, A16, or L40 GPUs can be installed. Some of them will also support an NVLink bridge to combine the processing assets of 2 GPUs into one. NVIDIA's H100 GPU features Hopper architecture and has a power draw of up to 350 watts. It's the only one of the bunch that requires a PCI 5.0 by 16 slot. The H100, L40S, and the L40 require a 16-pin power connector. The other double-wide cards require an 8-pin power connector and are fine in a PCIe 4.0 by 16 slot. As I said earlier, we have 4 NVIDIA L40S GPUs. They're like kissing cousins to the L40, but offer a bit more performance. That NVIDIA L40S is the go-to for AI if you don't want to spend the big bucks on the NVIDIA H100 or A100 GPUs. It's also listed by NVIDIA as the most powerful general-use GPU for the data center. It offers Ada Lovelace architecture with 568 fourth generation tensor cores and 48 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory with ECC. The NVIDIA L40S does not support multi-instance GPU support like some of the other GPUs that do allow each GPU to be split into up to 7 instances. With single-width GPUs, you will be limited to a 75-watt power draw supplied by the slots, and that includes the Intel AS-M 12 gigabyte, plus the NVIDIA A2 and L4. There's also a GPU riser module card holder for some of the smaller GPUs. With 4 full-width GPUs in the front GPU risers, you still have the opportunity to install some high-speed NICs or DPUs in those 4 slots at the back, hosted by risers 1 and 4. The NVIDIA BlueField-3 DPU can provide a single port at 400 gigabits per second. Up to 3 can be installed. The BlueField-3 DPU is perfect for use with GPUs, providing a super speed connection for accelerated computing and AI. Apparently, these BlueField DPUs are being used with NVIDIA RTX GPUs to help generate the visuals for the LED screens at the Sphere in Las Vegas. Also great for remote direct memory access, or RDMA, over converged Ethernet between GPU servers for AI workloads. With the XA, you get a GPU bonanza, and either up to 4 double-wide or 12 single-wide GPUs powered by 4th or 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors. I do hope you enjoyed this overview of the 2U Dell PowerEdge R760xa server. If you did, then hit that subscribe button. Want more information on this system? I placed a few links in the description below, or you can use that link right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.